Children, which lesson now we are learning? Dogwood, the village in the plateau. Okay, first you have to know the lesson name perfectly. That's why I am telling in every class the lesson name. Where is the Dogwood already? I said this is in Telangana state near to Mahbub Nagar, in Mahbub Nagar district, Gayavadra Mandal. Okay, this means comes from the word Dogwood. Why dog? It is called Dogwood. So many records lived in that area. Now from many years ago. So this area comes from this name Dogwood. Later Dogwood. First it is called Dogwood. Then it is changed into Dogwood. Okay. Already I said about the climate and rainfall of this village. Now we are going to learn about the soils. How are the soils? Which type of soils are here? How it is good for cultivation to grow crops? Okay, let us continue the lesson. Soils. Which type of soils are here? Red soil and black soil. Red soil, it is also called Erra Nelam. We call it in Telugu Erra Nelam, as well as black soil called Nalla Pravi Nelam. So listen here, red soil is not very deep or fertile. It mixed with the sand and some rocks. So it is not a deep soil, not fertile. Because of that, it is not good for agriculture. Some areas only can cultivate agriculture. Do not retain much water because of that rocky land. This area do not retain much water. This area cannot hold that water because of that lack of nutrients, and also nutrients also very less in this area. Lack of nutrients in this red soil, agriculture cannot take much. Half of the land only for agriculture only. Actually half of the land is agriculture for cultivation, but because of not deep and not fertile, low rainfall, so cultivation is not taken much in this soil. And next come to the Nalla or black soil. Do you know black soil? This is very sticky. Whenever the water goes into the soil, that water is very wet and sticky. If we go to that soil, 60 centimeters depth. The soil is 60 centimeters depth. That soil is not deep, red soil. But black soil is 60 centimeters depth. This area of our small part of agricultural land. But this area is suitable for cultivation, to grow crops, more fertile. This area can hold the water, retain water for much time than red soil. Can hold the water more and can retain the water in this soil much time. Because of that, this area is suitable for growing different types of crops. So more water can sustain in this soil. That's why in black soil only, this is a small part, agricultural part. But we can cultivate crops in this area than red soil. But half of the agricultural land is red soil. But how is the soil? The soil is not fertile, not very deep, do not retain much water, lacking nutrients. Nutrients also very less. Plants need nutrients which is mixed in the soil. They take that nutrients to come out. For crops, nutrients are also very essential, which are dissolved in the soil. If the nutrients are not available in the soil, crops doesn't grow well in that area. Okay, very small part in the area, in this area is black soil. Of course, it is suitable for crops. We can cultivate here some of the crops in this area because of a fertile land and water. Here water can, this soil can hold water for more time. The soil is very sticky. When we go into that soil, you go and observe some red soil and black soil. If you have in your area, go and observe the red soil and black soil. What is the difference about the red soil and black soil? You can find the difference. This soil cannot hold the water for much time, but black soil can hold the water for much time. You can go to that soil. Your feet will be very sticky when that soil is wet. After it is drying, means there are some cracks in the soil. Go in your area, if there are any soils, go and observe the red soil and the black soil. If anywhere, if you went to. Okay, children. In this class, we studied about the soils of Dhofar village. What you learned? Which soils are found in the Dhofar village? Red soil and black soil. In before class, what I said about climate, rainfall, and physical features of Dhofar village. This is in our Telangana plateau. Is in Balsan Deccan plateau. Already I said. Remember that Telangana is the Deccan plateau is the largest plateau in India. Okay, go through this lesson once again. That we will discuss more.